Plenty of shooting stars have been on view in Naples this week. Not in the skies of southern Italy, but in the Mostra d'Oltremare arena to the west of this historic city. The best rifle and pistol university shooters in the world showing their prowess. And it's the sixth and final day of competition with a mixed air pistol event over 10 meters at these Universiads. It's the first time we've had mixed competitions and they've gone very well so far. We're going to kick off with a bronze medal match between Italy and India. Who will go home with the goals? Their confirmation of the start list is Varicchio and Di Martino of Italy against Paramananthan and Greville of India. So Italy leads 6-4 in this bronze medal match. We're preparing for the sixth round of shooting between Italy and India in the bronze medal match. Varicchio's at a 10.4. Super start for them in this round, and a poor 9.2 for India. 9.9 for Di Martino. Again, Greville is last to go, taking his time. 9.4, not enough. And another 2 points for Italy. They lead 8-4. Italy have just won another 2 points, and Roberto Di Donna is delighted with that. The pressure now is on India. They can't afford to slip further behind. Been a real pattern so far. The Italians preferring to shoot more quickly. They have 50 seconds, of course. And the Indians, especially Ashal Greville, taking their time. So far, the Italian tactics have worked. 9.9, Varicchio, a good 10.3. Greville has gone early this time. 10.1 for Di Martino. 9.5, and Italy have won two more points. They're on a brilliant run because they were 4-2 down. And it's all going right for the Italians. Maria Varicchio, who studies psychology at the University of Benevento. It's a pretty good thing to study, you know, because there's a lot of psychology in this sport, as you can imagine. And as you may have heard, it's 10-4 to Italy. The concentration you can see on Varicchio's face. You see the eyeglasses as well. They're all individually made. It's a fascinating element to this sport is the equipment. With the blinders I was talking about, the eyepieces, not really to improve vision as much as to improve the depth of field to allow the shooters to focus on the gun as well as the target. We've had a 10 dead for Martino, 9-1, and a 10.2 for India, and they will come back and reduce the gap to 10-6, 4 points. A poor shot that time from Varicchio, only 8.2. Extra pressure when it's a team competition. You know that your teammate is depending on you. It's up to these shooters to rise to the occasion. Tension grows in Naples. A bronze medal is at stake. 10-6 for Italy. 2 points, remember, for each round one. 16th the target. A good 10.3. Varicchio, that's a good recovery. Not so good for Martino. Only 8.8. Oh, he won't be happy with that. And only 8 for Paramananthan. Well, that's sensational. Poor shooting by India. And it's 12-6. To Italy. The crowd making plenty of noise. Paramananthan, a disappointing 8.0. And that cost a dear. It's 12-6 to Italy. 16 the target. it's a white hot atmosphere. You know, we're not far from the famous São Paulo Stadium of Naples Football Club, and there's a football style atmosphere here. Italy are moving closer to a medal at the Mostra d'Oltremare. And another 2 points, it's 14-6. They're within 2 points of a medal. And I think Roberto Di Donna is just as nervous as the two shooters. 10.3 and 10.5 for Varicchio and Di Martino was enough. It's a match point for Italy. And a bronze medal is within the grasp of Di Martino and Varicchio. And it's a convincing lead, one has to say, 14-6. India can afford no more mistakes. Who will shoot first? Varicchio for Italy, 9.5, not the best, but it might be enough. There's only a 9 and a 10.6 for India, but that's going to be enough because a 9.9, that was brilliant from Greval. He had to shoot to a very, very high level, and he did. He hit a 10.6. Well done to Ashal Greval from the Punjabi University, studying public policy. 14-8, but it's still match point for the hosts, you know. They have a little bit of breathing room, but they want to finish it up as quick as they possibly can. Ashal Greval also on the taller side, 1.80 meters, although he's 5 centimeters shorter than Di Martino. So 8-14, Italy need 2 points. And they will have the bronze. Oh dear, 7-2 for Varicchio. That's very poor. 8.6 for Greval. And this time it's Paramananthan who does the business with a 10.1, the highest score. And slowly but surely, India are clawing their way back. It's 14-10. Surely the Italians won't throw this one away. But they've lost the last two. One senses the pressure growing on the shoulders of Di Martino and Varicchio. Cries of Italia. I wonder if it's helping the pair though, or is it adding pressure on Di Martino and Varicchio on the right of your screen? Well, let's see who will be first to shoot. It's Varicchio, 10.4, that's more like it. 10.4 for India and a 10.6, and India have it again. India have 2 more points with a 0.8-point win in that round, and it's back to 14-12. Oh, the sensational scenes in Naples, because from 14-6 it's 14-12, and the Indians are refusing to give this one up. Another match point. Support for the Egyptians, as you can see, not much compared to the Italians. 14-12, it's another match point, but it's suddenly getting very close, and it's suddenly turning into a classic final. 14-12, Varicchio 9.9, will that be good enough? Italy have the bronze medal. What a shot from Di Martino. The pressure was growing, and just when he needed to come up with a big one, he did. 10.7, and it's a bronze medal, a famous bronze medal in Naples in this mixed air pistol event. Di Martino and Varicchio. My word, they made these fans suffer, though, because they were so far ahead at 12-6. All credit to India. Paramananthan and Greval pushed the Italians all the way, but you can see the relief there on the face of Dario Martino, the local boy. Di Martino has a bronze medal, and Team Italia have their first medal. 6 days of top-level shooting in Naples comes to a climax with a gold medal match in the mixed team air pistol competition. Italy have won the bronze and the gold medal will go to Asia, but will it be South Korea or Chinese Taipei at the top of the podium at the Mostra d'Ultramare Arena? The South Korean pair, Park Tae-hoon and Kim Min-jung, must start as the big favourites. They were absolutely outstanding in two rounds of qualifying. But Yu Ae-win and Kuo Kwan-ting will look to cause a surprise to deny the Koreans and bring the medal to Chinese Taipei. These two countries, the last two hosts of the Universiade, in fact, Chinese Taipei and South Korea, the shooting stars of the Universiade on view for the last time. We're getting ready for the fourth round of shooting in this gold medal match. And Chinese Taipei have started really well. Yu and Kuo, they won that last round by 0.1 points. So only 8.9 for Yu, that's disappointing. What's Park got up his sleeve? On paper, the best shooter of the four. Impressive career behind him already as Park Tae-hoon had a gold medal here early in the week in the individual competition. He's going to go last again. He's taking his time. He's got a 10.9. Well, he took his time. And my word, that was the right decision. It's the first 10.9. And that makes it 4-4 and quite comfortably so. While I was building up Park Tae-hoon, he lived up to that billing. That was a superb shot, 10.9, and it's 4-4. It's 4-4 in this gold medal match at the Universiade in Naples. Remember, we'll just add the score for each of these shooters, and the winner gets 2 points. It's 4-4 at the moment. The favourites, the hot favourite, South Korea, on the right of your screen. 10.4 for Yu of Chinese Taipei, 10.6. It's very solid, isn't it, from Park? But a poor 9-1, and that means Chinese Taipei go back ahead. It's 6-4, and it's going to a pattern, isn't it? Chinese Taipei getting one, and then South Korea getting one. It's gone that way so far. That's why it's 6-4. And this would be a surprise if Chinese Taipei can hang on. There's a long way to go. They won that round by 1.2 points, which is a big gap at this level. Chinese Taipei leads 6-4 in this gold medal match. And Yu again shoots early, only a 9.8. And suddenly Park is growing in stature. Looks like he's growing in confidence. He's got the experience of 10 for Kim, 10 for Kyo, and it's another big one for Park, 10.7. Brilliantly done. And it's 6-6. So it's 6-6. You just saw the Chinese Taipei coach there, Tsui, Jade Tsui, who'll be proud of her team for getting to the final. They're going to go home with at least a silver. But when, you know, when you're in this situation, you want to go home with a gold. The qualifying scores, 580 for South Korea and 570 for Chinese Taipei, which is a big gap. Because Italy, who came third, 569, India, 566, Iran, 566. So you can see what a domination it was in South Korea. But that doesn't mean anything. We start from zero. And Chinese Taipei have the points again by 0.4 points. They lead 6-8, and that was poor by Park's high standards, only 9.4 for him. So it's 8-6 for Chinese Taipei. What a good start they've had. Those are the outsiders, no doubt at all. All those hours of training, concentration. Work so much on stability as well as upper body strength, just to keep that stability. And the ability to keep still, so important for these shooters. 10.4 for Park. 10.4 for Yu. is the big round. 10.9 for Kim. Brilliantly done, Kim Min-jung. From Seoul, Ewha University. You cannot ask for more than that. Brilliantly done. The target for the pistol, the center target is 11.5 millimeters wide. So well done, Kim Min-jung. She was a Youth Olympic gold, a Youth Olympics bronze medalist in 2014. And a 2017 World Cup final winner, that over 25 meter range. So the woman on your screen now, Kim Min-jung, certainly knows what it means to compete at the very top level. A World Cup winner in Beijing this year as well. That's why I was saying South Korea really have the favorite status here, but Park's only hit a 9.1, you know. And I think it's going to be 10-8. Indeed it is, to Chinese Taipei. It's gone from one to another. It's gone Chinese Taipei winning around to South Korea all the way. That pattern has been maintained since the very beginning. And if it stays like that, it'll be a huge surprise and Chinese Taipei will have the gold. Remember, 16 points is the target. It is 10-8 to Chinese Taipei. Over 10-6 for you, nicely done. 9-8 for Park, might be a bit disappointed with that. 9-9 for Kim, pressure on Kuo now. 9-9, and you know that's going to be enough for Chinese Taipei. Surprise developing here, Chinese Taipei lead 12-8. After a combined score of 20.5. Just waiting for confirmation of that score. Confirmation of that score, as you may have heard over the PA, it is 12-8. 12-8, the first to 16 gets the gold medal. Tension is rising, but they need calm nerves. Just need to block out everything going on around them. We've had an early 9-8 for you, so disappointing, Chinese Taipei. Only 8-9 for Kim, 9-8 for Park. And that's another 2 points for Chinese Taipei, who are just going further and further ahead. And they have a match point. A real surprise. And South Korea's shooting, quite inexplicably, just seems to have gone awry. The experience of Park Dae-hun and Kim Min-jung is not being brought to bear here. And Yang Kap-siok is their coach, you've just seen, perhaps telling them, just calm down, get back to the basics. Chinese at Taipei are on the verge of a huge success here. 14-8. A gold medal is now theirs for the taking. Yui Wen and Kyo Kwan-ting are on the verge of a big surprise. For the next competition, the vast experience of Park and Kim is not being brought to bear. They trail 14-8. You can see extra concentration. especially Yuai Wen there from the National Normal University in Taipei. Well, only 8-4 for Yu. A chance for South Korea to pull 2 points back. 9-6 Park, 9-5 Kim. It's not really the level they'd want. 10.5 for Kuo. And that means that Korea win the points by 0.2 points. My word, that's close. But as I was saying earlier, it doesn't matter what the margin is, 2 points goes to the team that wins each round. So 14-10. The gold medal still within the grasp of Yu and Kuo of Chinese Taipei. Yu has tended to shoot first these last few rounds. And that's the case again, 9-6 for Yu. I think we need a big score from Park. 10-2 for Kim, that's pretty good. The Chinese Taipei have it, they're 20.4. And there's a sensation in Naples. But well done to Yu Ai Wen and Kuo Quanting. Chinese Taipei have the gold. And what a performance it was for them. And you have to say it was quite convincing. 16-10. Disappointment for South Korea. But Chinese Taipei deserved that. They shot far more consistently. And a gold for Yu and Kuo in their sixth and final shooting competition in Naples. Silver for South Korea, they'll be disappointed with that. They dominated qualifying so much. 10 points was the advantage, but it doesn't mean anything. Once you get to the final, we start afresh. Italy on the right with the bronze medal and the smiles from Chinese Taipei. Some surprise, but a lot of pride as well. And they will make the long journey back to Chinese Taipei with a gold. A much shorter journey for the two Italians because they're both local, you know, Di Martino from Napoli and Maria Varicchio is from Benevento, not far from here. And they'll be celebrating tonight with friends and family, many of whom are behind me and celebrating the silver medal. There'll be some regrets, but Park Dae-hoon and Kim Min-jung have a silver medal at a prestigious event, and they can be proud of that. But the gold medal, and undisputably so, from Chinese Taipei, Yu Ai Wen and Kuo Quanting. Yu from the National Normal University in the capital, and Kuo Quanting from the Fujian Catholic University. From Taipei City as well. Well done to them. Gold for Chinese Taipei.